Hello children, welcome to Social Science. Today we are going to learn History Lesson 1, Society and Culture in the Ancient Tamil Kingdoms. Sangam Age, the period between 300 BCE and 300 CE was referred to as the Sangam Age in the south of India. The region known as Tamilagam extended from Tirupati in the north all the way down to Kanyakumari in the south. We also learned that the Pandyas, Cheras and Cholas were the dynasties that controlled the south from before 300 BCE right up to the 14th century CE, except for the period when the Calabria's invasion took place. Children, the southern part of India were ruled by three kings: Cheras, Cholas and Pandyas. They are collectively known as Moovendargal. Each of these three kings had two centers of power, one inland and one coastal, the port city essential for trade. Of these six cities, two were very important: Puhar or Kaveri Pumpattinam, the port of the Chola, named for its position at the mouth of the river Kaveri on the Bay of Bengal, and Madurai, the capital of the Pandyas. Now, let us learn more about these three ancient South Indian kingdoms. The Pandyas. The Pandyas were the earliest of the Moovendar. The early Pandyas ruled parts of southern India from around 4th century BCE till the 16th century CE. Korkai, modern days Tuticorin, was their early capital, and later on it was shifted to Madurai. The legendary Sangams were held in Madurai under their patronage. The fish was their emblem, as we have seen, and the Pandyas were experts in water management, agriculture and fisheries, especially pearl fishery. They were also experienced sailors and sea traders. The Sangam age of the Pandya kings ended when the Calabras took over the Pandyan regions around 3rd century CE. Around the 7th century CE, the Pandyas reclaimed their territories from the Calabras and re-established their empire. There were frequent conflicts between Pandyas and the Cholas. Nedunjayan was the most famous Pandya king, believed to have defeated the combined force of the Cheras and Cholas. In the 14th century, the kingdom met its end after an invasion by the Delhi Sultanate. The Pandyas subsequently became a part of the Vijayanagar Empire, which we will read about later. Next, the Cholas. The Cholas were the longest ruling dynasty in the southern India. Their kingdom extended up to Vengadam, that is Tirupati in the north, with the Kaveri Delta as its center. The Cholas ruled in two distinct periods several centuries apart. The early Cholas ruled in the Sangam age, while the imperial Cholas ruled from about 1848 CE to 13th century CE. Of the early Cholas, Karikala was perhaps the most famous ruler, and the buildings of the Grand Anakhat or Kallanai, a stone dam over the Kaveri to prevent it from flooding and to develop agriculture, is attributed to him. There are many references to him in Sangam poetry. The Tamil poem Pattinapali gives us information about him and his reign, and the bustling port city of Puhar, very important for both domestic and foreign trade. The Sangam age Cholas had their main capital at Urayur, which is part of present-day Tiruchirappalli, and the secondary capital was the port city of Puhar. Puhar is otherwise called Pumpuhar. The Chola kings used the emblem of the tiger, as we have already seen. The power of the early Cholas declined after the reign of Karikala. Next, the Cheras. The Cheras were the ruling dynasty of the present-day state of Kerala and southern part of Tamil Nadu. The recorded history of the Chera dynasty is broadly divided into two phases, the early Cheras and the later Cheras. The emblem of the Cheras was a bow and arrow. The Chera capital has been called Vanchi and Karur in several works. However, it is fairly clear that the capital was near the famous port known as Muchuri. Senguttuvan was the most celebrated Chera king and finds mentions in the Silapadikaram. The Pathu Pattu gives us some information on the Chera kings. They were in continuous conflict with the neighboring Cholas and Pandyas. The Chera kingdom was known for its trade with West Asia, Greece and Rome. Precious stones, pearls and spices were exported from the Chera kingdom. Muchiri on the Malabar coast was a major port. Next, political structure in the Sangam age. Army. In Sangam age, the king had an army with four divisions: infantry, cavalry, elephants, and the chariot forces. Swords, shields, lances, spears, bows, and arrows were some of the weapons used. Forts were surrounded by moats and trenches. Religious belief. Each region also had its own predominant god. So in the hills, Murugan was worshipped, known at this time as Seyon. Indran was the god of the plains, Varnan of the coasts, and Mayon of the forests. Buddhism and Jainism were also followed by some people. Status of women. Women were treated on an equal status with men. Sons and daughters had an equal share in property. Education was not prohibited to women, and there were many wise and learned women, as is shown by the poetical works of over 40 women's poets. In Sangam age, women can select their spouse. The caste system or Varnashrama was not there in those days. The Varna system or caste affiliation based on occupation prevalent at this time in northern India was a system that came into existence at the later date in the south. Children, in Sangam age, Tamil people, they had well-developed civilization. No caste system, no child marriage, abusion, exploitation, all these idiotic things were not there. And the lifestyle of women is fully equal to men. Children, in this lesson, we learnt Sangam age, the three important dynasties, political structure, status of women, art and literature, and army. With this, I conclude this lesson. We'll meet in next class. Thank you, children.